Welcome to two examples of determining the drops per minute of an IV. To determine the drops per minute, we're going to multiply the flow rate in milliliters per hour by the drop factor, and then divide by 60 minutes per hour. This will give us the drops per minute. And the drop factor is the number of drops it takes to equal 1 milliliter with a specific type of IV tubing. Before we take a look at our first example though, I do want to show why these units work out to drops per minute. If we start with milliliters per hour, which I'll write in fraction form, and multiply this by the drop factor, which is in drops per milliliter, and then we divide this product by minutes per hour, notice how the units of hours simplifies out, as well as the units for milliliters, leaving us with drops per minute. Now let's go and take a look at our first example. The drop factor is 20 drops per mil, and the flow rate is 150 mil per hour. Find the drops per minute. So we'll have the flow rate in milliliters per hour, which is 150 milliliters per hour, times the drop factor, which is 20 drops per mil, and we're going to divide this by 60 minutes per hour. Now we could find this product and then divide, but I'm going to encourage you to simplify first. The two most common drop factors are 15 and 20. Well, if we have a 20 here in the numerator and a 60 here in the denominator, notice how these two do share a common factor of 20. Therefore, we can simplify the 20 to 1, and there are 3 20s and 60, so we can simplify this to 3. So this would simplify nicely to 150 divided by 3, which we know is going to be drops per minute. And now we'll go ahead and find this quotient. By hand, we would have 150 divided by 3. There are 5 3s and 15. 5 times 3 is 15. We subtract, bring down the last digit of 0. There are 0 3s and 0. 0 times 3 is 0. We subtract, we have 0. So our final answer would be 50 drops per minute. Let's go ahead and check this on the calculator. Of course, with a calculator, it's not as important to simplify first. Let's verify both of these. Let's first do 150 times 20 in parentheses, and then divided by 60, which was the original setup, still 50, or 150 divided by 3, of course, is still 50. Let's take a look at another example where we actually have to round. Here the drop factor is 15 drops per mil, and the flow rate is 145 mils per hour. So to find the drops per minute, we would have the flow rate in milliliters per hour, which is 145 milliliters per hour, times the drop factor, which is 15 drops per mil. And we're going to divide this by 60 minutes per hour. Again, before we work this out though, let's simplify it. Looking at just the 15 and the 60, since 15 times 4 is 60, we can simplify the 15 to 1. There's 1 15 and 15 and 4 15s and 60. So now we could write this as 145 divided by 4 drops per minute. This quotient will be much easier to find by hand than multiplying and then dividing. 145 divided by 4, there are 3 4s and 14. 3 times 4 is 12. We subtract. Difference is 2. Bring down the 5. There are 6 4s and 25. 6 times 4 is 24. We subtract. The remainder is 1. We want to round this to the nearest drop or whole number, so we'll have to go to one decimal place to determine whether to round up or down. So per decimal point here, bring it up to the quotient, add a zero, and bring it down. There are two fours in 10. 2 times 4 is 8. Subtract, which gives 2. We can stop here. The 2 tells us to round down, which means this would be approximately 36 drops per minute. Again, let's go ahead and verify this on the calculator. Originally, we had 145 times 15, and then divide all this by 60. Again, this rounds to 36, or the simplified form of 145 divided by 4 will give us the same quotient. I hope you found this explanation helpful.